the NFL on EA Sports as we welcome you to MetLife Stadium here in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Miami Dolphins and the New York Giants. The longtime Panther Graham Gano has us set for a start as we are underway from MetLife Stadium. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Down to two, we're going to get a timeout here. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Here's Tua. And going deep for Hill. That's caught at the 25. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Well, if they didn't get the wake-up call before the game, they got it right now. Two plays already in the end zone.
I think of it in boxing terms because whether it's a big shot with your first one or a probing one, a little bit of a jab, the second one was the payoff. That was the big one that landed. 1-2, end zone.
Jason Sanders now for the extra point. And that makes it 7-0 Dolphins.
Makes the score Dolphins 7, Giants 9.
Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. Jones and the Giants now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And he whips that one incomplete there. Charles, already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. They'll try to run for it with Barkley. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Give him 7 yards on the play, and they do pick up the conversion on third down. They keep it with Barkley on first down. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
They were not fooling around at all, were they? Second and short, and they brought out the heavy package. Almost felt like the super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up front, and it turned into an easy first down conversion. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
On second down, here's Barkley. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a third down and two. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Barkley inside handoff. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. 2 yards is the pickup, and it'll be a New York first. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
Now this pass into the hands of Saquon Barkley, and he's going to be brought down at about the 16. Well, it seems pretty clear on this opening drive that they want to get him involved, not only, Charles, in the run game, but in the pass game as well. And he can be such a weapon for them when they utilize him this way.
And partner, you know I'm a veteran, right? In other words, that means a little bit older. Back in my day, we used to call
him. And he will take it all in for a giant touchdown. Saquon Barkley, a 16-yard touchdown run. And the Giants are able to match the opening drive touchdown against them with one of their own. Extra point try, good by Gadeau. And we are tied at 7. Had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. A fairly short kick from the 14. And he returns this to the 22. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent author a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
On second down, Mostert. And some room to maneuver. All told, it's an even 30 and a first down.
A gain of 30. First down.
These two teams all tied after one. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10.
Striker, 3, Plaster, 6. Black shot. 10.
Tua sets up to pass it. This is caught inside the 15. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Tanner Connor, 41 yards. And the Dolphins have moved out in front.
For good reason, quarterbacks want to get the ball to the perimeter to their wide receivers for big plays. But in this situation, it felt like, based on coverage, he knew that he wanted his tight end to have the football, and for good reason.
Extra point up and good by Sanders, and that makes the score 14-7. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And they're going to start in a hole as he's brought down at the 11. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. After that last score we just saw, now 14-7, so a chance to march down the field here, try to tie this football game. But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Saquon Barkley running right. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down, because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Now Jones. Yeah, that one's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
And that is how you respond after taking one on the chin to begin this game. Give up a first drive touchdown, go back out on defense, and completely shut them down to force a three and out.
Throw. This one goes out wide for Barkley. And unable to break away, they stop him a few yards shy. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And now possession's going to go over with a football at the 20-yard line. Tua getting it quickly out to Waddle. Touchdown, Dolphins! Tua finding his old Alabama teammate, Jalen Waddle. And the Dolphins are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders, and it's now 21-7. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Here's Jones, throwing to start the drive. Finding Sterling Shepard for his first catch. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line. So that changes things a bit. Here's a first and 10 all the way down at the 35. A handoff to Barkley.